Life is about choices. Now is the time to either leave the room or choose to change. What you're about to see will change your life and possibly save it. All involved in creating this series have done so with the full intent of preserving life, mainly your own and the ones you love. As for the bad guys, and you know who you are, beware.
I have no weapons. If for any reason I have to defend myself, be it right or be it wrong, then here are my weapons. My empty hands.
Give us the money!
Guys, take anything you want. Take the money, everything. Just don't hurt.
What was that for? Because I felt like it. Let's go!
Fight back. You've trained so hard. You're ready for this. You can take it. Get up.
If you're looking for trouble, came to the right place.
On second thought, come and get it.
I'm Chuck Zito. Most of you know me from the HBO series Oz, some from the Howard Stern Show, and others from the Van Damme Incident. What you have just witnessed here was Chuck Zito's street survival system. With a little common sense and some training, you too can survive these streets.
Sacrifice each and every day. Work and work, they try to snatch it away. They say there's no justice on the streets. They say the streets bring justice. The streets bring justice. The streets bring justice. The streets bring justice.
In this day and age, it's time we stop ignoring what's been happening all around us. Every day, every hour, there's a chance you may be confronted by a violent criminal. It's time to stop saying, this can't happen to me or the ones I love. It's time to say, hey, it can happen to me. The training system I've developed will change the way you see your everyday surroundings and help you find the warrior within you. I'm going to teach you how to think like a fighter and, more importantly, like a criminal, which will help you avoid confrontation altogether. Welcome to my world. And I'm going to show you how to survive in it. Let's start with the basics.
Every good cook needs his own apron. How do you like mine? Hey, watch it. Now I'm going to show you my secrets to healthy eating. You know that old saying, you are what you eat? If you eat bad, you're gonna feel bad. And worst of all, you're gonna look bad. But if you eat healthy, you're gonna feel good, and best of all, you're gonna look good. When I'm in my training regimen, I go on a high protein diet, which consists of steak, chicken, turkey, tuna. I stay away from all dairy products. I'll cut my carbs down to once a week. But if you need carbs, have whole wheat pasta. If you need butter, have margarine. If you need milk, non-fat milk. If I get hungry during the day and I want a snack, I'll have some fruit. Oranges, apples, bananas, grapes, a grape. Now I'm gonna prepare a few healthy meals to help you make a change in your eating habits.
Basic food rules. All natural ingredients are always the right choice. Check labels. Choose foods that have no artificial colors, flavors, or preservatives. Don't overeat. The amount of food you eat is just as important as what you eat. So serve yourself smaller portions and fight the urge to go for seconds. Save seconds for special occasions and holidays. Cook with fresh ingredients, free-range or organic fruits, vegetables, and meats. Cooking with butter is actually healthier than margarine. The trick is moderation. But if you want to lose weight quicker, substitute the butter with margarine only when dieting. The most important thing to remember is you can diet all you want. If you don't exercise, you'll never be in perfect health. So incorporate any type of exercise into your daily routine. Now, cooking your own meals aren't only tasty, but they're healthier too. Whoops. Let's start with fresh sautéed peppers and onions. Take peppers, onions, mushrooms, and garlic and sauté them in a wok with olive oil. After it begins to caramelize, I add a splash of red wine and cook for another 5 minutes. I then store it in the fridge. It's great to use for breakfast, lunch, or dinner. For breakfast, I enjoy cereal with fresh fruit and non-fat milk. It's delicious. For lunch, take a whole wheat wrap, some fresh turkey, and that's right, throw on the peppers and onions. I also love making tuna salad. Make sure you get tuna in water, hard-boiled egg whites, celery, relish, low-fat mayo, and a splash of balsamic vinegar. Mix it all up and you have a delicious low-fat meal. And lastly, dinner. Take a steak, spread on Dijon mustard, and cover it with fresh ground pepper. Now put in a broiler for a few minutes, flip and repeat. Sauté garlic and string beans with olive oil, and serve with a small portion of rice. In volume two, I'll give you a few more healthy tips and tasty meals, so you can continue with healthy living through healthy eating.
Hey, do as I say, not as I do. But the bottom line, you go on a high-protein diet, you train regularly, you too can cheat once a week. Because this stuff is good. Before starting any exercise or boxing routine, always warm up your body first. Get that blood circulating and those muscles warmed up, and you'll be less prone to injury. Use your bedroom, your living room, your backyard, your roof if you have to. Now let's go start working out for a healthier life.
These are the basic warm-up exercises, so watch what I do and follow along. This series is designed to show you part of my routine so you can incorporate it into your own. I want to take this time to discuss the more important aspects of street survival, the mental aspects of training. While you're warming up, mentally begin to prepare yourself for the training session ahead. It's important to clear your mind. Concentrate on perfect form with all your warm-ups and techniques. Fighting is probably the oldest of all physical workouts. I mean, before sports or athletics were ever defined, the human race had to fight for survival, which means that's what our bodies are built for. Like the lion in the jungle, it was born to survive, therefore built to hunt and fight for its territory. Us as humans have been so civilized that we forgot what our bodies were initially designed to do. Like the lion who's put in a cage or raised in captivity, it becomes lethargic and just lies around, kind of like a couch potato. This is your time to break out of that cage and become the man or woman you were born to be. Hey, I'm not here to train you to become a killing machine. I'm here to build your body, your mind, your confidence. You don't have to be a professional fighter to become confident. You just need to know and believe that you can survive. Stretching and strengthening your neck and jaw is very important, especially when being at the receiving end of a punch. Having a loose neck and strong jaw is key. You can recover quicker and return the favor. Just open and close your mouth to strengthen your jaw. You see what happens to a boxer when he takes too many hard shots to the jaw. Lights out. When stretching, bounce lightly or hold. If you bounce too hard, you can injure yourself. With this leg stretch, you want to keep both feet flat on the ground. Feel the stretch. I advocate exercise, any kind of exercise, and you don't need fancy machines or gadgets. Everything you learn in this series you can do in a very small space without any equipment. The equipment we use in this series is of the highest quality and are great tools to help you excel, but by no means are they mandatory when it comes to working out. And reach side to side. This is a great stretch and a great strike. You get both with this warm-up exercise. I'll show you how to use your knees as weapons in just a few minutes. When you're done learning the exercise on this tape, create your own routine. Pick some of your favorite music and train to it. It allows you to groove to your own pace and move to your own rhythm. Having a great abdominal area is the fitness industry's greatest excuse for ripping you off. Everyone wants the latest ab machine or gadget to make their abs ripped. Here are several different exercises to help rip your abs. Notice there are no machines or gadgets around, just a mat. But of course you can use a blanket or pillow or the rug if you're home. The point I want to make is this. Stop making excuses for not training. Look, I'm 50 years old and I train. The best sit-up exercise is any sit-up exercise. The worst sit-up exercise is no sit-up exercise. If you want strong abs, do sit-ups. If you want ripped abs, do sit-ups and diet. It's that simple. I like doing my push-ups on concrete using my knuckles. It hardens your skin and adds to your knockout power. That's why I'm responsible for more blackouts than Con Edison. You can do your push-ups open-handed on a mat or rug, whatever you prefer. Jumping jacks. I think I learned how to do these in kindergarten. They're a great way to warm up your whole body. Jumping rope is also a full body workout. It increases your heart rate and develops your arms, shoulders, and legs, as well as it helps develop your coordination. Now when it comes to equipment, I use the best, and that's Everlast. Why? Because they've been around since 1910, which makes them the oldest boxing distributor in the world. So they must be doing something right. Now let's get down to basics. Now I'm going to show you how to wrap your hand. Wrapping your wrist, thumb, and knuckles helps avoid injury when training full contact using boxing equipment or when sparring. I'll show you drills using equipment further into our workout. You won't need wraps for the majority of today's workout unless you decide to train using boxing equipment. Wrapping your hands is essential when training full contact. Now I'm going to show you how to deliver a proper punch. Every good building needs a strong foundation. This is your foundation right here. I'm right-handed, so I'm gonna lead with my left leg and my left arm. Your hands are up high. In case somebody throws a punch, you're blocking here. Body shot, your elbows are here. So block on top, body shot. So you're gonna throw a jab, jab straight out, bring it back. Straight out, bring it back. When punching, slightly rotate your body into the punch. These are good body mechanics. Your punches should snap out and return to the guarded position. Notice the body's rotation, shifting your body weight into the punch. If you throw your punches with just your arms, you lose all the potential power.
Right hand.
Rotating into the punch creates power. Again, notice my body twist into the punch, and my lead hand is high in the guarded position.
Jab, jab, right hand.
Flow from jab to right hand, twisting into each punch.
Let me jab, jab, right hand.
Double up the jab and throw the right hand. It's good to play with your timing. It can throw off your opponent's rhythm.
The hook is this way.
Twist into the hook, keeping your elbow level with your fist for maximum power.
Just pivot your body. It's like the chubby check, you don't want to twist.
Now work the jab, right hand, hook.
If you miss with a punch, come across. Hit him with the elbow. The elbow. Come back, hit him with an elbow.
Your elbows are vicious weapons. Again, twist your body into the strike. The most important thing to remember about multiple strikes is that you might not connect with the first few strikes. Keep striking and moving into your opponent. Eventually, you'll hit pay dirt. See? Now this next punch, the uppercut, I'm going to show you through this rope drill. I want you to step, bob and weave, and keep your hands up high. Now do the same and add the uppercut. Notice how my body springs up and generates power. The rope simulates someone's arms. You avoid the rope by shifting slightly as you punch. This is called slipping a punch. Here's an example. I slip and deliver the uppercut to the body. Body shots are the best opportunity you have to connect with this punch in a street fight, and they can cause just as much damage as a headshot. Remember, beat the body and the head will fall. The myth about blocks is everyone thinks that you have to block hard. Watch any great fighter and you'll see that their blocks are actually effortless. Here's a more advanced technique using blocks and strikes in combination. If he throws a right, I block with the left hand, not giving him a chance to rotate into a punch and generate power. Block and grab his wrist while simultaneously striking inside the bicep or elbow, and quickly strike the face or neck with the same hand. Then slightly drop in the stance and strike his solar plexus with your elbow. Quickly switch grips, spin into an elbow strike again to the solar plexus. Then back fist to the groin or thigh and end with armbar and wrist lock. Here is the same technique with more striking possibilities.
Basic punches I just taught you, the jab, right hand, uppercut, left hook, Will's gonna demonstrate on a heavy bag. So you can see the proper form and you can practice yourself.
While hitting a heavy bag of shadow boxing, always visualize an opponent. Notice how Will always keeps his hands high after every punch. You keep them high because whenever you throw a punch, it is highly likely that your opponent will follow with punches as well. You can now easily block them and continue striking. If you get into the habit of letting your arms drop while you're training, then you'll let them drop while you're fighting. Always throw more than one punch. One punch only works in the movies. Even I double up on my punches, just to make sure. Now when training with a partner using focus mitts, you can incorporate all your punching basics. More importantly, you can begin to feel what it's like to actually move like a fighter without sparring. This drill teaches you to stick and move, bob and weave, and react after you throw a punch. If you don't move after you throw a punch, you're going to get whacked, and it doesn't tickle. But when you begin to relax, breathe normally and flow, it will be difficult for someone to hit you with a loaded shot. Two important notes about movement. One, it's hard to hit a moving target. Two, if you're moving, your opponent's punch will lack power, giving you the opportunity to counter with a hard combination, which is why you always have to throw multiple strikes, especially in a street fight. The other great thing about this drill is that both training partners are getting a workout at the same time. Now it's time to step it up. Using these basic boxing techniques as your foundation, we will now begin street applications.
Finger strikes to the eyes, to the throat.
The eyes and throat are your two best targets when you're up against a stronger opponent.
A woman could do it. A little kid hits you in the eye, it's going to hurt. Remember, there's rules in the ring, there's rules in the octagon. There are no rules on the street.
Raking the eyes is a woman's natural defense and clearly very effective.
Palm strike. Chin, nose, forehead. If you hit them under the nose far hard enough, you'll push that bone right up into their brain.
Keep your fingers together and strike with your open palm.
You might say, ooh, I can't do that. But you know what? It's either hurt or be hurt, kill or be killed. And if it comes to those two choices, you will be able to do it. Ridge hand to the throat, side of the neck.
Ridge hands are very effective when striking in both directions. You can chop to the neck, chop at a joint area to break a bone, or knock a bone out of socket. Mix them up with other strikes.
targeting the collarbone, armpit, and groin area. For the next 30 seconds, I want you to shadow box using the basics I just showed you. Jab, right hand, hook, elbows, uppercuts, finger jab, rakes, and palm strikes. Front kick to the stomach, groin area, or knee is an effective way to stop your opponent. Lift your knee high and thrust your foot forward, putting your whole body into it. It's especially effective if your attacker is running at you. Their momentum will help you create more damage. Of course, timing and accuracy is all part of the mix, so practice slowly at first and then build up your speed. Knee strikes are great when fighting close range or grappling. A good knee strike to the thigh will give your opponent a wicked Charlie horse. For the next 60 seconds, I want you to shadow box again, this time incorporate the kicks on the knees. The headlock is one of the most used street fighting techniques. Everyone has experienced the headlock. It's a very difficult move to escape from unless you know what you're doing. Calmly reach over in between your head and the person who has you in the lock. Just reach under his nose and press hard. At the same time, grab his groin. If they don't let you go right away, just wiggle your finger under their nose. The pressure point under the nose is extremely painful. As they release, quickly strike them in the throat. That should give you enough time to escape quickly. You want to get out as quickly as possible, mainly because they might have friends and they can easily beat you down while you're locked up. When getting choked, you have to move quickly. When being choked from the front, simultaneously strike the knee with a kick and clap the ears hard with your palms. Then grab and shove your thumbs into his eyes, trying to pluck out his eyeballs. It's a lot harder to do than it seems, but he'll definitely get the point. I know it sounds brutal, but the fact is that a choke can render you unconscious in just a few moments. A few moments later, you'll be dead. If he still has a grip on you, reach around and put your thumb between his index finger and thumb, hitting a pressure point. Now twist his hand into a wrist lock. With your other hand, go inside the elbow. Locking his wrist and applying pressure will drive him to the ground. Now be creative with some finishing strikes. Bend your knees and step to the side, simultaneously striking with the elbow to the solar plex and a back fist to the groin. Take the same hand and jam your fingers into his throat, grabbing his Adam's apple. Quickly twist your body as you go down on one knee, guiding his body over your knee. Strike with a rich hand to the windpipe and elbow to the sternum. Finish him off with a lock or strike. Have some fun. The next choke from behind starts the same. After the initial strikes, lock out his wrist and step behind him, applying an arm lock. Now you can choke him. Bring him to the ground by applying pressure behind his knee, knocking him off balance. A perfect opportunity for multiple strikes, including a face bump. We'll be right back.
grab from behind, don't struggle until they put you down. Then quickly stop his instep with the heel of your foot. Deliver a headbutt by thrusting your head back. The headbutt can not only daze him, but can knock him out on his feet. Now step wide and spread your arms to break his balance. Quickly turn and grab both his legs for a takedown. You're in a perfect position to mount your opponent and finish him with multiple strikes. Another defense for the forward choke are simple pressure points behind the ears. They are extremely painful and you could add pressure to the throat area as well. The body has many pressure points. Okay, we've covered the basics. Hand strikes, leg strikes, body mechanics, pressure points and escapes. If you practice, these basics become second nature. Just like walking down the street. Now, the only way to truly train is to visualize and drill. This takes a lot of self-discipline. Don't only throw punches and kicks, throw lots of punches and kicks. Break down all the techniques you've just learned and do them over and over slowly until you perfect them. Looking into a mirror is a great way to check your own form. Whenever possible, train with different partners. Remember to empty your cup and fill it with new knowledge. Training at a boxing gym or martial arts school is always a good idea, but not necessary when training for street survival. Now it's time to visualize. For the next minute, I want you to visualize your opponent. Every block, every punch should have emotional content. This isn't kickboxing aerobics. It's the real deal. This is the warm-up round before our final three-minute rounds. you need to flow from one technique to the next. The second you have to stop and think about a technique, you'll not only lose the fight, but may lose your life as well. You know the old saying, practice makes perfect? The more you practice, the better you get. Whether it's playing the piano, making love, or my Street Survival series, I'm only perfect at two of those things. Oh, by the way, I don't own a piano. I want you to be comfortable in your own skin. Train slowly at first. It allows your mind and body to become in sync. Rushing through your training will only make you sloppy. Speed comes with practice. Now's the time to dig deep. You're exhausted. You feel you can't go on. Now's the time to find the warrior within you. Like I said before, there are rules in the ring, there are rules in the octagon, but there are no rules in the street. The name of the game is survival. 3 minutes left. You have the heart of a lion. Rule your domain.
Every year, thousands of people have life-changing experiences. Not just people. There is something to be learned by the survivors of these horrific experiences. The lessons lie in the answers to these two questions.
I parked my car in the daytime, but by the time I got out of the mall, it was dark and I couldn't find
He jumped out, knocked me down.
I'm shocked.
I was actually in the wrong parking garage.
He was going to kill me. If I didn't do exactly what he said.
They were across the street. They seemed normal.
Looking back, I heard something, but I didn't think anything of it.
I got a bad vibe the moment I saw him.
I saw them coming, and I couldn't do a damn thing about it. It felt so wrong. It felt wrong like a bad movie.
That's all I remember.
This ruined my life.
We want to now focus on a career criminal. The people that actually commit crimes for a living. The real bad guys are cowards. They look for easy targets. Who's an easy target? Anyone who pretends it can never happen to them. Instill in your children never to talk to strangers, especially those in cars, where they can be easily abducted.
Hey, buddy, you know where the Scranton School is?
4 blocks that way.
But if there is an attempted abduction...
4 blocks that way.
A woman could do it. A little kid hits you in the eye, it's going to hurt.
Even in a dangerous street situation, little Johnny remembered the finger strike. That one technique probably saved his life.
Your child should run to a neighbor's house or a public place, like a supermarket or a gas station, and have the people in charge not only call you the parent, but also the local law enforcement agency so they can arrest these pedophiles while they're still on the street. Same scenario, different outcome. She sees her attacker and quickly disposes of this punk maggot motherfucker. She now has the training and confidence of Bushido, the warrior way. It's almost as if she enjoyed it. By the way, that's my mom. Notice the resemblance? This guy is about to get into that awesome vet. Hearing footsteps behind him, he quickly turns. And because he had a plan, he instantly knew that stepping away from this type of an attack could actually cause him more damage. By closing the gap between him and the lunatic, he has stopped his momentum. Jamming him, locking over his arms, striking his throat, disarming him of his weapon, and turning the tables. By using this type of mental training, it will be impossible for anyone to surprise attack you simply because you already have a plan.
No justice on the streets. We say the streets bring justice.
So let my street survival system volume 1 put you on the right track to find the warrior within you. And remember, make love, not war. But be prepared for both.